Hello, how you doing? We're gonna do a quick sky video. I'm just on a roll. I just feel like doing it. You're gonna see my reference image right down here. Boom, boom, boom. And it's a photo I took a while back. It's kind of doctored up, and it's not an awesome photo. But as for stimulation for what I'm gonna do, you're gonna notice in this area in the photo things go a little weird and green. Don't care. Just give me some ideas. We're going to make a painting. And we're going to do it very quick because I don't have a lot of time today. I'm working on my book. And I got to finish a chapter I started. But yeah, I'm working on the book. But the fact is, I'd rather be painting today. I know you know what I mean. Anyway, so the board is hardboard, two layers of my own transparent gesso I've created. And I've oiled it out so you can see the true color of the board. You gotta have a bit of a buffer. Bit of a buffer. This is a Robert Simmons. I'm gonna take that all the way off. So. Well, I think one of the good things about having you being able to see the reference is you can see all the things I'm going to change. See, there's a lot of weird duplication there, and I made things dark. There was actually a street or something there in the original photo, and I don't like. You notice how I'll lean on the side of my brush sometimes. This is called mass drawing. I'm using black. I don't recommend using black unless. You're planning on getting right into the painting, and we will be because I gotta try and get this done within. I don't want to spend an hour, and that's point of my brief for today. These trees up at the end here. See this move I make with the side of the brush? That's just to keep me doing some mask stuff, right? Debating actually even not even doing any pre-mixing here, just mixing as I go, because that'll save me, might save me time. What I'm doing here is I've decided I'm going to do some reverse stuff. And it's really more about the sky. So I dip my swab in a little bit of oil. Give it a second. See, it's any effect. Enough of that. Let's do some cloud drawing. Gonna take my glasses off, So in the reference, it's like loop, loop, loop. I don't like that so much. I'm gonna straighten things out a little. But I'm just taking inspiration from the reference, and that's one of the main reasons, one of the main things I want to impart. That's a bit of 1, 2, 3, but I think I'm gonna offset it like that so it's not too repetitious. This I debated just filling in a corner, and I did it in the reference photo, but it's nice. I want this offset a little bit, this mass here. So you gotta design your clouds, you gotta design your trees, you gotta design everything. Sky painting really mostly about clouds. And you can see I'm taking some pretty massive liberties. So I kind of like this, how this sort of dusky quality. I've added that color, which looks a little artificial in the photo, but will work brilliantly as, you know, just something to get me out of straight up. It's going to be kind of a dawn scene. In fact, maybe I'll call it Painting a Dawn Sky. Maybe that'll be the name of the, this is the water, and we have some nice waves here. Ooh. I see that came up too high. And this is seen as just a bunch of nothing anyway. Let's just take that way down. Because I like this light color coming out. That'll be cool. And then we'll offset it. Now you wouldn't want it in the same spot. We're going to bring it up a little higher. Smaller. That'll be another light one. And then of course we have waves here too, so that'll be cool. Like that. Now you notice I took, I'm not paying much attention to this rocky shore. It's not a painting of a rocky shore, and also, yeah, I don't really mind what's up with that. I might go in a bit dark here. This is lamp black I'm using right now. Pick a light source coming in from here. It's not that distinct in the, even if you have reference, by the way, that has no, like, it's like this isn't got a strong light source. Pick one, pick a direction. You don't have to get real, I mean, it's not like you're going to create a lot of real strong So, really, you know, I'm laying a lot of different information on you. And you might go, oh, you just did a sky video. There's so much, painting is so complex. I could do 20 sky videos and still not, you wouldn't be learning everything there was to know. I'm not saying you need to watch videos to learn how to paint skies. The best way to learn how to paint a sky would be by painting a sky. Let's get rid of some of this, and get rid of the grid. I'm gonna dip in my paper towel with my oil, and we're working quick and dirty today, so we don't mind too much. Now this drawing, the reason why I do this stuff is just because it's our best chance. I want that a little off. So, friend here. So hopefully you're getting some ideas, like, why is he changing everything? Well, because I'm designing it, and if I just made copies of the clouds the way they were, well, I've done that, actually, and I know things aren't always going to work out. I kind of done enough skies, I kind of know. Let's put this in. And so it's fine. Basically, one of the things I'm always trying to teach you is, like, set up some patterns, you know, that make sense to you based on the reference. Don't just try and copy the reference or trace the reference or any of that. How simplified things are. It's a bit like a puzzle, right? Not that all of these are going to be razor straight on the bottom, I just think it's helpful. So one of the widest, brightest clouds is here in the reference, and I like that. Yeah, I'm okay with that. I think we're pretty much done with the drawing now. That's why I don't do nothing. That's all right. I don't need to worry about it. So looking at spacing intervals, I'm wondering, this one, I don't know. I don't know about you. Good boy. Let's try something a little more connected to the other guy. Also, these two is like one on top of the other. Something's got to give. I think I'm just going to come over a little further here. Right, and then here, just another mess over here. Like that. And it's not like all of these have got to be straight, like I said already. Up a little. everything's done. So your eye is going to move through things. We'll open that up a bit. We'll pull back on this. I like to lean back. Too carried away with the straight thing. I'm liking that. Not bad. Let's just jump into some color. Well, no, I'm going to do some pre-mixing because I'll tell you why. It's really hard on the brush. And this way I can work with a knife. So let's pause that for a minute. Still may have oil. Let's see what's going to happen. It just starts biting through. Well, you say my... You say you got to design. I don't know how to design. Well, this is how you learn how to design, by designing. There is no other way. You have ideas, you implement them. You see, I've done a lot of different things with the clouds. I'm basically pretty happy with that. Yeah, now I had to check. Well, that might mess with my slightly wet painting a little, but we're trying to be careful. We're just going to do some basic colors here. So, yeah, if I was to, like, I want to go home, I want to have lunch, but I started this, and I did it with black, so I painted myself in the corner. It'll be weeks. So blue doesn't really identify itself. Wow, this is so much darker than what I want. Like I've said before, and I'll say again, don't mix, over mix. If you're going to pre-mix some color, I'm just going to do some basics here. Yellow ochre, soup. Let me finish what I was going to say first. If you're going to do pre-mixes, don't go too light. Yellow ochre, by the way, brilliant color for... You see how there's that hazy bit in the middle there? Now that's muddy. I agree. Don't worry. As you add the white, it'll fall in line. this is going to be a quick dirty painting, and who knows, probably won't be a masterpiece. It could be. We'll see once we start painting. Either way, it doesn't really matter. You can't let that be the determiner of what you're going to do when you're going to do it. I'll do a pinky color. You're sitting there. Well, there's a crimson, also a great color for skies. There's some warmth in it, though. I'm going to bring in some of that orange. Oh, that's nice. And like I said, these are not Perfecto Mundo mixes. These are just something kind of set some parameters, get us going. Let's do something for that blue water, eh? Bluish. We'll put a little phthalo in that. A little phthalo go a long way. Ooh, pretty. That's too vivid, though. So we got some black. Quite a lot of black. You can see that actually isn't too far off from what's in the reference. Maybe I need a little more. There's a little more blue in that. A little white. We're going to put that there with the sky colors because, just because I feel like it. I don't want to mess up my drawing too much. I do a lot of my cleanup with a little bit of spirits in a little eyedropper bottle like that. So the spirits, I use these really quite nice spirits that are super odorless. They're pricey spirits from the art supply store. I don't use a lot of them, and I appreciate the odorlessness. All right. So I generally like the palette clean before I'm going to get in there and get into dark colors. Because the colors in the sky all generally have some white in them, but the colors in the land generally don't. The colors in this land really don't. So we'll just pop a little black. Actually, we'll go ahead and mix the black with some burnt umber. I've been doing that quite a lot lately. Looks like I had some sky blue in there. That's good. I think for this painting I'm going to break out, by the way, on my palette. Let's just clue you into what's happening. Let's hit. I know we're getting all the new people all the time. You probably wonder, what are the colors there? Titanium white, titanium buff, cad yellow, yellow ochre, raw umber, Mike's green, that's acrylite yellow and black, cadmium yellow, cadmium red, burnt sienna, fake burnt sienna. It's PR101. It's actually transparent red oxide. Burnt umber, real burnt umber. Alizarin crimson permanent. Phthalo green. That's permanent green light. We ain't going to use any anyway, so I didn't put any down there. Diazine, you never know, might be a factor. This is some ultramarine blue, and this is just lamp black. And these are just some colors left over from another painting. Looks like they're going to sit there because. Really, they're not that. Maybe I could use some of them, make some of those browns. Is this skin? A little bit of a skin on there. Take that skin away. Let's start with that, actually. Some brown. It's kind of a nice brown. I'm going to degreenify it. Cad red. We should blast that green away. Some orange, more of that. Basically need one brown and a green, and I'm gonna call it day on the landscape colors. Just making myself just plain old kind of reddish brown. You see the colors in the reference, you know what I'm all about here. As far as the green goes, make some of that nice green, a little black. A dark. But the greens in this are dark. I think that'll be alright for now. And I'll mess with it a bit as I'm painting. So, just got some basic colors here. Alrighty. Alrighty. Let's start painting. We got an hour. That was all the prelim. I like that one. I'm going to use this for most of the sky. Take the glasses off. Now, when I got blue sky in a painting, I like blue first. So, get a little bit of medium on my brush. And we will go a touch darker. I don't think there's any black in it now. A little bit of skin, raw umber, brilliant color for skies. You can see how that's falling into the reference much better. Raw umber is really the secret. Did I do too much? Probably not. Let's get a little more blue in that. So I want a little darker on top. So when I pre-mix, I don't mix. You can always get a little more freshness and color back. You don't want your sky over smooth. We want to see the strokes. Working pretty thin. Like that. Oh, here, I really want to change it up. I want to go lighter. So I'm going to wipe off my brush. And I believe my next color would be just lighter. I'm also going to bring in some of this now. Some kind of a transitional area. This is a place where I decide how things are going to be as I'm painting. But I'm also feeling, I see a little something, so I pull things from the reference. Now the deoazine is kind of, it's drying up on me, but it's still holding in there. I don't know. Get into a little bit of a purpley off as we get into here. I really should be getting lighter too, but not so concerned with lighter there. Maybe over here. Not like that. Okay, so I wiped off my brush. I'm gonna start here. I'm gonna get in some of this. You can see it was pretty dramatic last time. This will be even more. punch in my painy little hair. You're excused. Is that rain? It's rain or wind. Like that. And then it's that pink below. Okay. When at the area where they meet, we'll see what happens. I'm gonna start with the pink. So wipe off the brush, get a little more oil. That pink. And a lot darker in the reference. I didn't bother dealing with that. I just knew it wasn't gonna paint it that dark. What is that? Skin dry paint? Similar in value, right? So it'll get on. Now I'm gonna bring in, I have some more of that other blue color there, so. Now this brush would be what I term a floppy brush. A little into some more orange on this side. I'm not going to. I now I can sit here and get real, go real slow, but I'm going to take a shortcut. If you don't mind, horizon lines are straight, so that's what I'm going to do. So we said, what do you mean? Well, how else would you do it? Well, good question. Just like that, you know, a little slower, but I'm going to hurry. It's quick painting today. I'm backing in purple if I have any left. If I don't, I'll just bring in, not purple, but you know what I mean. I'll bring in some more of that. Maybe a little purple too. Deoxine. And maybe a little more of that blue. Tap lighter and a little tiny bit of yellow and a little bit more orange, and that does nothing. Too many other colors on my brush, so start that over. That's not the be all end all. We'll just call that what that is for now. And up here, I'm gonna get into like that color in the reference. Is what I want to be at. Maybe a little more blue. And that was that white, blue, and yellow ochre. And you can see yellow ochre is totally magic for skies. And really, it's a great color for landscape painting in general. Dry paint there. Let's get a little more saturation there. So we'll do that with a tap of cadula. That would have to be lighter to do the kind of magic stuff I want to do there. Yeah. Right. Any real colors for the clouds, but in my mind I was thinking just bringing in some grays and things. I don't have any Mike's Gray mixed, which is a drag, but sort of the gray. Crimson. I really don't like the colors in that one right now. Instead of like, if I wanted to match what was in the reference, I might go burnt sienna. I'm gonna modulate into more red, pinky red, orangey. It's a little dirty. It's kind of good. It's sort of, let's do that with a little, I want a tap darker, so I'm gonna hit a little more, a little bit of this crimson. Big secret. See the value shift there is not so great. So it looks airy. This guy. Ooh, I guess more orange is the only place I can go. And with orange, I got to bring in white because otherwise it's going to get weird. Also nice because it's not super different in value. Just to get these guys sort of married together and make this the same color. I have to modulate though because I'm addicted. So a little more red and a little more white. I'm addicted to modulating. And you should be too. It's kind of getting into some sky color realm, but up here should work good. reference. Let's try a little yellow. Maybe something good will happen. Again, yellow plus white. I do like that bit of real oranginess in the reference there. I think that's cool. So I need more orange in my palette. I need more, maybe. A pinch, of course, yellow. And it's too dark. Yeah, so I'm not using a lot of my buff in this one. Yeah, I'm liking that. I don't want to overdo it. Let's get back into these and back to some gray. So that's just black because I don't have Mike's gray on my palette. A little purple. I need to squeeze out some orange. I know what you're doing. We're rocking and we're rolling. Now, there's not a lot of strong highlights in these clouds, maybe you notice that. I think that's one of the things that attracts me to is a little flat. It makes it a little different than some of the ones we've done. Alright, back into this gray. Get some oil. Gray. And some purple. Just pulling in light colors from there. Saying I slow down when I hit those edges, you know, a bit workmanlike. Yeah, so the idea I had was this cloud in the middle is lighter. That's kind of cool with the value of this guy there. Yeah, like that. And let's go ahead and do a little lighter version. Use some of that sky and a bit more purple. Darker, which fortunately we have some of that darker color here. And then here I want to change it up yet again. Brown umber. Good color for skies. So the ideas pop into my mind as I paint, and that'll happen for you too if you paint more often, okay? So what's popping in my head right now is, what about some just regular gray, like we have all these tinted grays. What about a gray that's just black and white? What about that? Because that'll have its own sort of color feel. Like that. I don't know why I'm thinking about that on the bottom here. So people look at these types of paintings and think, oh, that's not that creative. Really, you think not. What about here? I do like that color. I don't know how much of it I want to do, but it's also hitting other colors in my brush at this point. That's cool though. I like that. So what I want to do there, maybe just a nice pink. We've already done pink down there, but it's a little different. Whoa, what was that? More hop on. I had just tapped the brush a little in to some. I just barely tapped some. That's from Crimson. Yeah, real pink up there. Let's go. That's why I was talking about that. That's why I was tapping the crimson, because I wanted a pink. I'm gonna modulate a little with the a little more, you know, injected with color than the pink I did there. A little darker. I'm gonna use a little bit of. I use a lot of littles. I know in my conversation. Sorry. I was a little raw umber, but also some black, because it'd be cool if the value is not too bright with that dark patch of sky. This painting's pretty fun. Will it turn out good? I can't guarantee you that. But I'm having fun. I like that. That's a nice modulation there. Different, of course, from the reference, but good. Let's get rid of some of that board color. Nice. I'm still being finessed a little bit, not with the color that's currently in my brush. Yeah, I just had to get a painting done. I mean, this, I like working on the book, but if I'm not painting, if I go too many days, I did a little drawing yesterday, but for my NS. That same blue kind of that's there. That. Now, I maybe want to get some purple, more purple. So, most of the purple I brought in has been very subtle, and that, of course, is off the chart, but I doled it with some of the grain stuff there. Do it here too, why not? Yeah, I like this brush for skies because it's what I would call floppy, loose, bristly. Nice. In general rule, you got some purple one spot, you want another two. That's good there. Not that much different in value from what was there, but tying things together, which is what we want. That's nice. So what am I going to do there? Maybe a little orangey. Let's go a little orangey. I don't know until I do. Condense a few things on the palette here. Some of that color from the sky earlier. I just want to go a little lighter here. That's a little bit of white and a little bit of yellow ochre. That's nice. I need more white. So what could happen to you if you take my advice is you'll get to be like me, where if I didn't paint today, I just would feel kind of not right. I can go, like Sunday I don't paint, that's my day off. Monday I painted a little bit, but I know today I have scheduled to work on the book I'm working on. It's a little like that. So I know when I go home for lunch, that's it for the day. So what do we want to do there? I think we'll start with this color, which is like that color. Like, they don't need to be making a brilliant statement. Oh yeah, that's what I grabbed that for. I was thinking more orangey, but not a bright orange, like a duller, darker orange. So let's try some burnt umber in that. So, you know, generally speaking, the bottoms of the clouds are a little darker. But I still want some payoff. Did I go too far? I don't know. Yeah, I could add a little black to that. Let's see. That's a nice color. I do want to do some modulating there, but I covered most of it because it's getting to be a pretty tiny little spot. By the way, sometimes what I'll do here is like I need to get in a small summer spot, I'll flatten my brush and do this kind of thing so that I can get in there and have a little bit more control. See? Orange, white. Paint inside the brush. Should still be a different tone than the sky. Not by much, but it's okay. I want it kind of subtle because trying to get the water vapor in there. That's nice. That seems a little darkish now. What have I got? Just make something with the black here. Maybe a little crimson. What a liar. It's white in that. White in the sky will help you reconcile things. So here there was a pop of much brighter white. I'm gonna try it. If I don't like it, I can get rid of it. Wipe my brush off. Just work in, instead of working into a pile, just work over here by itself. There'll be something in my brush, right? Which will be help modify a little, get a little yellow ochre. And again, the stuff in my brush, a little more oil. In my brush is a bunch of that. That's kind of nice. Am I out of oil again? I'm out of oil again. There we go. Maybe I got too much oil now. gotta be careful now because I set up a 1-2-3 thing. Not brilliant, not smart, but can I get out of it? We'll see. That's nice. Yeah, a little brighter. You can see where I'm drawing inspiration from the referrals. So I bought my brush, which is getting a bit sloppy now, a bit. This bothers me here, but I think I'm going to go with some more color there. Cab red mixed with whatever's around, and a little lighter. It's got a little blue. That's nice. Yeah, pretty good with that. This sort of bothers me a little. Let's go ahead and put off our brush, see what we can do. It's not bad, it's just a little dark. One more life there. So it just, I kind of like, I've been doing this whole thing with my eye and glasses off, so let's get some black. Bro, I thought you said you wanted to make it lighter. Yeah, well, I gotta. That's nice. That should be lighter. Not lighter enough, though. With more white. It's getting a little thick. Wipe off my brush. Go a little lighter. Fancy pedancy. Let's go ahead and get some of this sort of sky color back in there. Oops, that's not right. It's not wrong. Let's go to the blue, some of that white and ochre. Start over. The way more so than the cat. Not hitting what I want. Blue. Blue. Poker. There we go. White. It's like the pink's hanging in there. It's hanging in there. Don't go away. It's all right. That's nice. I like that. He's still a little darky, maybe, on his own. Mm-hmm. So, maybe some of that little bit of reddish. It's mixing, you know, we can get carried away. I really don't want to. This is not a big painting, so yeah, I like that. The only thing that puzzles me is like what I'm doing there. Purple I made with gold. Yep, I like that. You might overwork it. Okay, we'll take a little break and then we'll be right back. Back. Well, I like that. That looks good in the camera. Now, I could see little things here and there that aren't, you know, my favorite. But you know, you gotta learn to listen. You get over your perfectionism. I know, because I am a recovering perfectionist. That's from when we had the board up there. Nice. Okay, so we use the same brush. We'll get into some of this sky color. I want to modulate. Maybe a little more aqua too, make it pretty. Wow. Okay. That's the color I mixed. That is actually pretty good. Talking about using that T-square there. Well, this is the alternative, but because I already have the square there, I don't necessarily have to. I'm going to modulate that a little brighter. We're going to put in some cad yellow and white. It's not going to be massive. I'm doing it this way is I need that straight, but I don't want it razor-y. It's already, you know, obviously the horizon is always going to be somewhat razor-y because it's pretty sharp. One more of that, and as we're on the edge there, we're going to get some more of this. Messing up. Okay, back to. Actually, it could have been a T square to give me that. Back to plan B, which is mix a little lighter yellow. Sorry, I can't show you, but it's yellow and white. A little thick in some spots, but nice. So I built up a paint, you don't necessarily want that there. Well, like that, that's good. Okay, down here I didn't want to go light, so let's bring in some blue. Blue, blue, blue. But the blue, it's the ocean blue after all. More blue. More blue. What is that, dry paint? Is that what you are? It's not going very dark because there's a lot of white in my brush. So and that's pretty deja vu. That's how we made that original color. Probably it's the original color. Close enough. A little darker. That's good. It's a nice color. I like it. put some other things on top too. Not a ton. Like that. Because we know it's going to make it a little green. You see in the reference, it's got a kind of orangey thing going on there. Don't want that. That's nice. We know we're going to put in some lights there. In fact, hey, I think it's time. Really the brush of choice for that job, as much as I don't feel like getting another brush dirty, but I'm going to. Because you gotta know, sometimes you're lazy, I'll clean the brush. Well, it's gonna make you more work as you're trying to paint. You know, we have this, it's like sky color altogether. So I'm gonna grab some of that. A bit more. I want the light up against the rocks because that's where the action is. brush because I can get real much finer lines with this one. So I'm going to give this some little caps. Same here. Like that. Don't get crazy. Don't get crazy. I'm gonna do that same sort of technique I showed you with the other brush. To give me a little more fine. Just flattening the brush. I don't want that little bit to just drop down. What did you do that for? Okay, because it's a two-step process. Like that, I'm going to make it a giant project. This blue, though, might be nice, I'm thinking, just to put a bit more in a couple spots. It comes alive then, it was very, it's very dull when it mixed. I'll just give it a little pizzazz. Yeah, we'll leave that. That's not a, like I say, it's a bit of a steady. Okay, and what I want to do though is clean out this brush so I can just use it for the land. Rain. I just cleared my whole palette thinking I'm going to paint land, but I forgot I was going to paint the water, which is really much different from the sky as far as brush used and things like that. But that's alright. I ain't complaining. I do know for the most part in the land they don't want a lot of white, so I would like to clean my palette yet again. Good. Okay, we gotta hustle. We got to hustle. Yeah, we'll start with cleaning this oil thing out. It's getting all contaminated. A few stronger blacks in there. So the difference is, I mean, I was sketching before, although I did fairly thin. So vague in the reference, but this is not the focal point. The focal point is the sky. There, the frame rabbit. Yeah, that's just a little bit for some green things I'm thinking of doing. I like that. I believe that brush is black. Don't need oil, we made this nice brown. Let's start with a bit more of a reddish brown. Okay, it's hitting the stuff from the cleaned the brush, but the brush wasn't clean. It's alright. Not worried about it. We're working quick and dirty today. There we go. Get some more black in that. Maybe this will look better than the crimson. Alright, that's dark brown. So yeah, I'm not necessarily, I'm kind of just working off of, I've got a basic pattern kind of set up. It's pretty vague. It could have been, I'll be honest with you, I feel like I could have worked it out a little better. But I also know that this is kind of just that part of the sky. I'm going to have more greens over here, so I'm not going to bring in too much there. Maybe a bit here. Oops. Good. Now into my light brown, pretty much just as is. Get some more red. You said some more, that looks very red.
Yeah, well, we need some differences going on here.
A little bit of red will add some interest. Well, why did I pick red? Well, what are my options? You already got a ton of this burnt sienna in there, and it's not moving the needle much. So, burnt umber, of course, just make it darker. The yellow ochre, make it chunkier. Raw umber won't solve my problem. So it was cad red. That was it. That's what I had. Now, that'll look nice contrasting against this. This is my mixed color. So you could sit there and paint. I've done it, okay, folks? I painted those rocks painstakingly, and those paintings suck. Destroyed a lot of them. Some of you are probably even on the channel still, but I get pretty lazy about that. That's looking nice. I want to have more modulation there. I'm just going to go into the black, and because I got all this other stuff in my brush, it's not going to be black at all. You'll see odd artifacts from me using the spot healing brush from Photoshop. I don't really care because I knew I just wanted this sort of vague. That's too light there. Ships going down, all hands overboard. I get ready, get ready. Time to get rid of some green. Let's go ahead and actually hit a little bit of that. See, I told you I was right. I did flatten the color a bit, but that's okay. Better call might have been to bring in some of that. That's all right. It's okay. Because I don't want a lot to... Ooh. All right. Well, the music's not very loud. Hopefully it'll be all right. So, this green thing. We gotta get her done. I made it pretty dark for a reason. And I'm gonna chuck in some crimson. Crimson in your dark greens in the shadow is a good way to go. More dark, more green. I got other stuff in my brush. Oh, it's messing up. Oh, it's probably a bit subtle. Like that. Okay, time for some lighter green. Just my screen. I think that'd be pretty good, just into whatever's there. Alright, let's bring in some CAD yellow and some of this other stuff. Orange. More orange, some red. My dedicated light brush came really blue now, really blue. We're going to overwork it.
Big. It's a bit intense, but we'll blend it in.
Okay, I'm gonna shut a little more black. We done. We're gonna go. We're gonna get some lunch. I'm hungry. Is all busy, so I'll just do a little. And one of the reasons I opted to finish up with the black brush is black brush is pretty good blender. Some of those little pockets that are catching your eye. Some of them we want, some of them not so much. Pretty happy with that. That's working. Obviously, it's little trees in the distance. Yeah, good. Hey, nice little painting. Thank you for joining me today. Hey, you know what? If you got all the way to the end, consider leaving me a tip for the lesson, right? You know, that's all I want to say. Or go to my site and buy a couple of nice paintings similar to this there. My prices are good. They're not high. It could be higher, but you know, I'm aware of the times we're living in. Also, members area, you know, I pretty much talk my way through every painting I do, so it's not that dissimilar from this, except that I just show you the reference at the beginning. Let's go ahead and do a nice zoom in here. I'm liking this painting a lot. One of the reasons I've been sort of doing this is I kind of thinking of having a little series out here, you know, there's a couple of galleries that might like this kind of thing. Yeah, I'm happy with it. Hopefully you learned something. And there'll probably be more sky paintings like this coming. So I'm sorry Ash couldn't join us today. She's busy, but she's interested in doing some more. So until we come back, another painting. Oh, let's do the zoom in. Get that brush strokes, those are nice. Until we come back, another video. For your edification and enjoyment, do me a favor, do me a solid. Take good care of yourself, your family, all your loved ones, and stay out of trouble. Thank you for your support. Thank you for getting to the end. Leave me a comment. These paintings haven't been getting a lot of comments, which I don't find encouraging. I'll be honest with you. But, you know, if you made it this far, leave me a comment, leave me a tip, and God bless you and your family. Stay out of trouble.